Here's a question. Why sell with contingencies? A number of years ago, I had over a dozen contracts fall over or fall out of escrow within the space of a few weeks. These were due to contingencies within the sales contracts. In each instance, we had to relaunch the respective property and sell it again. Aside from the fact that this was a lot more work on me, I realized my sellers were the real victims. Relaunching a property after already being on the market for 6 weeks or so is not a good look. It damages the selling effort and it negatively impacts the integrity of the listing. I decided then and there that I was not going to accept non-contingent contracts moving forward. Many of my colleagues at the time thought that this was impractical. I figured that if I was proactive and I supplied all the relevant information, disclosures, reports, etc., up front, there was no reason we could not do it. So I did. Years later, 90% of my listings are sold without any contingencies. They are sold unconditionally. My average time on market is just 12 days. That's 12 days from when the property is launched to when it is sold with no contingencies. Obviously, the escrow or the settlement periods still apply, but everybody knows it's a done deal. With whatever you do, do not just accept the status quo. Innovative thinking often leads to efficiency, productivity, and improved practices. Once again, I'm Michael Mahon, your real estate success strategist. If you found this video helpful and informative, and if you feel that I've delivered some value to you, look below, like the video, subscribe to my channel, or follow me. And don't forget to smash the bell to receive more notifications.